When I left off last time, Pat had just walked in the door, sound man Pat, and quit. And we asked him to be our sound man. And pretty soon he quit his job and he went and bought PA and stuff. We bought all of our equipment down at a place called Halpin Music. And they loved us because, I mean, that's where my Roadmaster came from. That's where everything came from strings to everything we got. But we were still the Shadowfax band at that time. And it would have been Scooter, Denny, Jim, and me. And the four of us lived in a jam castle. Pat never did move in, but, man, they didn't have online stuff back then. So, I mean, Pat, had out of the back of a magazine, had got a blowgun. One of the big old long dudes, like, you know, over in Africa or somewhere. And we would, the jam castle, like I said, was 150 years old. At one point in time, it was the only house around there. Big fields of corn, or I'm not sure what they were growing. And they had a barn there. And it was so old, man, it was put together with wooden spikes and stuff. It was cool. Major stuff. But anyway, you can figure the jam castle, there was the bugs crawling on the wall and, you know, spiders and stuff like that. Anyway, Pat brought this blowgun over, and we'd sit there and shoot the blowgun at the spiders and stuff going up the wall, which was pretty cool. But we all had jobs at the time, and that's going to come important here down the road, and you'll see how that happens. But we all worked at the same time, and we practiced all the time, man. We had everything set up, and I never thought about it at the time, but I'm sure where that was would have been like their main dining room, because there was two great big sliding doors and you'd slide them open, man, and there was a great big room, and I can see a big table in there with the servants serving them the food and all this stuff. And we set up in there, and man, we practiced every day. We did not get a day off, and I wore a lot of albums out, because back then, I mean, there was no CDs or not, and you pick the needle up, move it back, drop it down. Pick the needle up. Oh, man, I got to get that piece. It ruined a lot of albums. Anyway, we were at the point where we were practicing all the time. We were getting really, really good and tight. But it was just the four of us in the band. And we went up, there was a place called the Matador. And we didn't have any regular gigs at the time, but people were hearing about us. Anyway, we went up to the Matador, and there was a band in there playing, and I can't remember the name of the band, but the Matador was kind of a rough place. Anyway, we went up and did a couple of tunes, and that was the only time I ever played anywhere with somebody else's guitar. I don't care if I got a Les Paul and he's got a Les Paul, they play different. Different strings, different setup, high, low, all kinds of different. It's the only time ever I ever played anybody else's guitar, although his was a piece of junk, and we didn't sound as good as we should have. But anyway, I'll stop there, because not too far down the road here, we become the house band somewhere, and I'll tell you about that.